I didn't really even equate the word alcoholic to what I was. Like, an alcoholic is one, it's a man, they're 50 plus years old. You know, they've got the trench coat on, haven't they? And they've got, yeah, the paper bag, like with the bottle in it. And that would, you know, I just don't fit that mold. I remember like one of the first times I tried to, you know, sort myself out, I was going to this sort of drug and alcohol center, and I'd got in a cab for them to drop me off. And they said to me in the cab, you know, be careful because there's loads of addicts there. And I, you know, so like, you know, even at my worst, I didn't quite fit the mold of what an alcoholic looked like. So it was really difficult for me to get my head around that one. Yes, I relate to you. Yeah.
Do you think that that is maybe part of the reason that you're outspoken and honest about your addiction problem? Because, you know, I think people look at you and you probably get this reaction a lot, like, you don't look like an alcoholic. Like, you don't look like somebody who would have had that problem. But as anybody who's been through recovery knows, like, alcohol does not discriminate. Like, it doesn't matter your age, your gender, your social status, how much money you have, what you look like. Like, it gets everybody, yeah. You know, if you've got that in you. So is that part of your motivation behind speaking out about your problems?